next guy up is going to be a guy that plays our nickel position, a position that was perfected by Jalen Ortiz and Tyler Hall in the last few years. Actually played at the same school as Tyler Hall when Allen was a freshman. Tyler Hall was a senior at Sarah High School. Anyway, transferred to Culver City. In most circles, this guy's going to be regarded as being undersized. But for us, his competitiveness, his athleticism, his desire to be great is what attracted us to him. We saw him at a camp. He was going up against the top players at that camp, was really competitive. Coach Bull saw him and said, this is the guy that's going to fit. We got to add this guy to our defense. He's a Cowboy. And once he knew that he was a Cowboy, he's never let up on that. Really excited to have Allen join us. Easton Gibbs, linebacker from Temecula Valley High School. This guy was the guy that we had as our second commit of the year. He's a Cowboy true and true. You know, he came up early in the summer, saw it, loved it, been committed to us ever since. Has been a really solid guy, one of those guys you never have to worry about in recruiting. He came from us from a program who didn't win a single game the previous year, became the leader, jumped in, played quarterback, and never complained about that. And so he played the previous year as a defensive position, but this year, whatever his team needed for the success, they actually made the playoffs, won a playoff game, and so really excited to have him. Another guy that we saw in person at camp, Coach Cooper identified him in the spring, another guy that we saw in person and said we have to have this guy on our football team. Next linebacker would be Isaiah Abdullah from Los Angeles Wilson High School. Again, this is not a program that would typically produce Division I football athletes, but this guy is long, he's athletic, plays multiple positions. Coach Richardson identified him in the spring. We watched him play throughout his senior year. Again, another guy that developed and fitting in our philosophy of watching guys their senior year throughout their senior year. So definitely a guy that's gotten better throughout his senior year. Defensive staff watched him in the middle and knew he was a guy that could fit in our defense. Moving on to the cornerback position is Caleb Robertson. Caleb Robertson is an exceptional athlete with great speed. He's the California state champ in the 300 meter hurdles. Now he transferred over to St. Louis and Cardinal River High School. He's signing, he's going back to California to go back and defend his title. Now, he's a really, really good athlete, really good coverage skills, good ball skills. You see him going both ways. I play for a really good team in St. Louis and came out here early on in the official visit process, liked it again, knew that this was a place that he wanted to be, and we wanted him, so excited about Caleb. Last guy here, but not least, is Jordan Murray from Murrieta Valley High School. Jordan, I think you can see, you're going to be able to see here on the film, is a really big-time playmaker. He plays a lot of different positions at his school. He returns kicks, he returns punts, plays wide receiver, makes big plays at wide receiver. And that was the one thing that we saw off film. We were actually watching somebody else and his play jumped off the film. Coach Cooper developed a relationship with him. Coach Richardson also developed a relationship with him. They worked really, really well together and bringing this kid in. He came in here again, saw it, felt like this was the right place for him. He's the right fit, and we're excited to be able to use this guy at corner, okay, but also in the special teams game and see what he can do, and maybe he could give us a spark on that end. And that's the summary of our signing class. Thank you.
Thank you, Justin. Well, that's a nice job by our recruiting office, and it truly is a team effort. We're really excited about this group. A couple things have added, certainly the number of years that our staff has been there, been out in areas. We launched into a new area, the state of Texas, and we had some ties and some familiarity with Texas, and that proved to be fairly bountiful. But a couple things, I think. We as a recruiting philosophy do not get into ratings on stars and things like that. We go by our ratings. But I can tell you that the competition that we encountered in recruiting some of these guys, they had a lot of options. And so A lot of the yeses and the confirmations, we believe, came from, first of all, you know, three consecutive winning seasons. Certainly, the McMurray High Altitude Training Facility, it set us apart from a lot of our peers, and there's a real buy-in. And the other thing that really occurred was our players, our current players, really are truly our best recruiters. And so the ball's moving forward. We're certainly excited about it. It was a heck of an effort by a lot of guys. I know personally, I feel like I'm rode hard and put up wet. I know our assistant coaches are as well. But this is a great capstone. Now, we'll need to come up and find some more players as we go. It's interesting, everybody has asked how people have handled the early signing date. Last year in FBS, there was over, I think, 2,100 roughly players who signed early. This year, that's numbered down to 1,500. So I think everybody's trying to find how to handle this. But we feel like we hit our watermark, and we're real well poised with the group that we have up there. I think some needs that we're going to continue to search for. Certainly, a quarterback is going to be important for us. I think a running back is going to be important for us. A bigger tight end will be important for us. A defensive tackle. But you know, we're on the inside, feeling really good about where we're at. We're in a great position. And so I want to say thanks to once again to our assistant coaches and Justin and the recruiting office. We're really pleased with where we're at. So at this time, I'll open up to questions from the media or anybody else who's here. So questions. Yes, Robert.
Mr. Kirk, were there, you said yesterday, there's always surprises down the stretch. Were there a lot of surprises, good or bad, today? Or did everything kind of go as you had kind of hoped?
You know what? It was probably about where we thought. There's always going to be, you know, a couple guys that commit that you go, well, I didn't know how they saw us. And then there's going to be a couple that, you know, change their mind. But it was pretty minimal. And I think we've got a system built in place to handle the slack both ways.
Just a quick follow-up. I know you recruit Colorado really well. Still time is, you know, do you feel good about what you're doing in Colorado? Do you think you might get some guys, or was it just maybe one of those years where maybe it's not quite as heavy as it was?
You know, I think there's, you know, it's going to sound like a somewhat of a boastful statement. I don't know if there's a staff that culls through the state of Colorado as more thoroughly than we do. And we certainly have done that. You know, there's going to be some guys that we'll continue to look at and actively seek. And so some years there's going to be more players that fit the Wyoming profile than others. Even though we're going to go in the back half, I don't think you'll see us sign as many, but we're going to continue. There's a couple guys that we still have on our radar that are in the state of Colorado.
What is your most,
over here, I'll come back.
Coach, you talk about, looks like you went after some size and versatility on the offensive side of the football. Was size of receiver and on the offensive line really important to you guys this time around?
Well, we've got a template, and certainly as we've progressed with our offense, the size and the stature is really going to be important. You know, when Justin was going through the tape with the receivers, one thing that we were looking for is a competitive guy to go up and catch the football, and certainly size comes into play. I think we identified those guys, and you saw them come up with contested plays. And then what we also feel like is important to do, and I addressed it about the middle of the year, to have much more of a competitive nature and guys who are going to finish things off and be competitive. And so I think we've identified that.
Yes. What were your most pressing needs coming into the early sign period that you felt like you addressed?
You know, a couple things. We felt like we had to get some guys in, particularly at the safety position. You know, we've recruited well there, though, but when you lose two seasoned players like that, we're going to need to continue to get that corner was going to be an important position, defensive ends, and then two linebackers. And we feel like in the Mountain West play, nickel was going to be important. Offensively, we felt like it was going to be critical for us to get a couple guys at that H position that could really stretch the field. And so between, you know, Traden and Christensen, you know, we feel like we've been able to do that. And so we're certainly excited about that.
So with Parker, and you guys recruited him all the times an H back, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What is he? I feel like he fits into that position. And could he get a look at running back?
We don't think so. Okay. You know, he's about 6'2". He's about 205 pounds. He runs 4.6, and he's an explosive athlete. So, you know, between Trayton and Parker, we feel like those are guys that we're going to need to be able to do some athletic things. A couple of years ago, we had Jacob Hollister here, and Jacob was one of those guys that could really do some special things, and we feel like we can get that with those two guys. Yes, Rob.
I'm curious, obviously, you still have offers out there and stuff, and now as you go into this second process, is it, you kind of let the dust settle and see what's out there, not necessarily start over or still continue on, guys you have offers to, or a little bit of both? How do you kind of approach it now moving forward?
Well, a lot's going to come about what happens today. I mean, there's going to be certain guys that felt like they were going to get signed that are not signed. There's certainly a template that we have. You know, we're going to kind of hone in on our needs that we have and certainly make sure we find guys that are above the line. We've already got a game plan in place that Mace has done a really good job with. And so we'll begin to reevaluate. But there are a couple guys that, you know, we've talked to and said, okay, you know, if this goes in the second signing period, we're going to still recruit you. And I think that comes into play on how everybody's handling this signing period. You know, last year I think there was an urgency, was a newness that, okay, I'm going to sign early. Now I think you're going to find more and more guys looking around. And so we'll continue to recruit those guys. I think that there'll be a couple guys that will pop up, but there's not going to be a whole lion's share of guys that all of a sudden we're starting from scratch.
You mentioned defensive tackle as a need. How pressing is that given you lost some veteran presence right in that middle?
It's always going to be important for us to build our defense with defensive tackles. So we feel like when that, we got one. We had specced out in a matrix to take two. And so we'll take a hard look to see if we can find one. We're encouraged by what's out there right now that we'll find one more. But I think we've hit our baseline with the exception of one. Yes,
okay. You guys have got some guys transferring out of the program. Could you sign more than 25 and count some back, or would that do anything to affect your scholarship numbers?
We're choosing not to do that. Okay. You know, and the whole transfer game in college football, everybody perceives it differently. I think it's part of college football. We're always disappointed when some players choose to leave our program, but we always, you know, want to wish them the very best. And this is just part of the nature. I think we're probably on the low end as far as the guys that are exiting. But as far as the gamemanship, I think you're going to hit some heavy ebbs and flows and counting forward and backwards and things like that. And so that's where we're looking at 24 to 25 guys. And, you know, for us to be at 18 right now, we feel like we're in a really good position. Yes?
Does the early signing period help, say, the schools at the Wyoming level, mm-hmm. and then you can identify what you're short of after you do it?
Well, we think it does. I certainly think it benefits the student athlete. You know, some of these guys get badgered and they commit and decommit. And I think it also has some coaches pump the brakes as far as when they're really going to tender some offers. We feel like we've been ahead of the curve. You know, our MO is to be a little bit more methodical. Some schools will throw out just tons of offers, and they're really, that's less than honest. Their approach is to say you've got an offer, and really it's just like Monopoly money. It's not real. And so we go through a vetted process, and so when we make an offer, and we're going to assume that young man's going to take it. And so therefore, the early signing date is really beneficial for us because you know, the gamemanship is over. Here's an offer. Here's the paper that's coming. We want you to sign. And so we do a great deal of work, not only in the spring, but in the summer. But we work a lot in fall. And a lot of our coaches were out in person. I was out in person a lot. And so we feel like the early signing date is advantageous. It also helps cut costs. You're not running around the country babysitting and things like that. So I know some schools were disappointed with the early signing date, but it's something that is here. It's here to stay. And we feel like it's an advantage for the Wyoming Cowboys. Other questions?